resistance. Oh, body punches, but he got caught with the right hand to the head there, and he's had to go on the run.
Looping left, jumping kick.
Tetsuka sees an opportunity here. He may run out of time in order to execute it, though. Perpetuo proving quite evasive in this round as Tetsuka switches his attack upstairs. He's not having quite the success that he had when he was going for the belly.
Tetsuka turned it up late in the first round. I wonder if that's a strategy of his.
Well, it's a 15-minute contest, Gianni, and that's long. Can't rely on what happens just in the first few minutes. It's a marathon, not a sprint, as they say. Taking the inside of the thigh there with those powerful legs of his, Tetsuka. But other than the first minute or so, it's really been about the fists.
Nice jab there, landed by Tetsuka.
Still both men, particularly Tetsuka, light on their feet. Very bouncy indeed, in fact, Japanese man. Lots of energy, and we're past the halfway mark in this contest. Slings himself into a left hook there. The jumping knee looking for the chin, but I think the gloves were between knee and jaw. Jab to the body from the Brazilian.
Tetsuka's not as clean as Perpetuo when he throws his shots, but he's got the power, Steve.
Do you think he's flagging a bit, Tetsuka?
It's possible. It's possible saving it for the latter half of the round.
Certainly open mouth, breathing quite hard. Still seems to be light on his feet. Still sending in punches that look very dangerous. There he goes, digs into the body and then brings it upstairs. Left hook to the body, left hook to the head.
Pretty combination. This
is really, really good. These are power punches. Got to have admiration for Perpetuo's durability here. Never really looked in trouble.
Zuko's got the pin on the cage now.
Nice little lateral movement. Made Tetsuka look just a little bit silly for a moment. Run like that.
1 minute left in the second round.
Final 60 seconds of this second stanza. Still Tetsuka in the middle of the circle.
Tetsuka putting the pace on Perpetuo, making him back up.
Perpetuo is the man that has to be the most mobile, because this onward, this forward movement from Tetsuka has been relentless. Left hook downstairs, right hook upstairs. Not many straight punches from the Japanese athlete. He has these lovely arcs that come in with tremendous power. And strangely enough, it was he who said to us in the middle of the week that he thought his opponent had a wide arc to his punches, that he might try and counter that with straight blows. We haven't really seen it.
Right cross lands by Tetsuka.
They're really slinging the two of them now. No real thought to defense. They're just swinging bombs.
Just like the first round, they end the round with a bang.
They really seem to save the best for the fight. And I think I see a little bit of redness underneath the Brazilian's nose. He lands a nice right hand, perhaps being aware of that injury and sensing some urgency. Just got spun around by his opponent there. A nice kick to the lower leg. Taking the support from beneath him. Tries to send one back.
Perpetuo has been starting the rounds really well. Tetsuka is the one that ends the round well.
You've got to watch out for the final 10 seconds of these rounds, because they just explode, these two. But great entertainment preceding that, must be said. And they're right in the pocket, these two, just as they were at the end of that second round, Gianni.
Same side, left hook, left kick. Just to throw off the rhythm a little bit. Nice, went to the right side as well.
Perpetuo shakes his head, saying, no, you have to do better than that. Once again, he gets on his bike. Because there's no stopping this forward thrust that Tetsuka seems locked into. Cannot change gears, can he?
All forward pressure right now by Tetsuka.
Tends to go body head, body head. Japanese man, and it's given him some success.
And it goes back to low kick again. Perpetuo has been landing with the hard leg kick, but I don't know why he's not going back to it.
Well, that leg kick's managed to strike the face and just knock his head back. But I wonder if he's done enough as we approach the final 3 minutes of this round. Now, what's he got here, Johnny?
Beautiful catch into a takedown.
Too slippery, I think, there.
Too slippery. Perpetuo is trying to lock up the go-go plata position, but Tetsuka is looking to pass.
Perpetuo managed that go-go plata submission in his last contest. That was in December. So it's not an unfamiliar move to him. Switching that figure four around. Going in with some elbows around the ear there. No contact with the back of the head, but as long as it contacts the ear, those are legal blows. Bringing his opponent in nice and close, denying him the space to work hard.
Yeah, just a little shot, short shot hit by Tetsuka.
What can he do with his back to the canvas in this position? Bringing his opponent in nice and close, Gianni, but can he advance from there?
Perpetuo can look for a sweep, draw up a submission.
The referee is, I think, warning Tetsuka about shots to the back of the head because there looked to be a couple there that landed clean on the back of the head, and we don't want those. Nicely done by the referee. Didn't make a big fuss about it, but made it very clear that he wasn't going to stand for any more. Working head, working body onto his legs now, and he's got his opponent pulling him down, so it's going to be hard work for those legs.
Yeah, nothing significant, but Tetsuka's landing a little short shot, just scoring Perpetuo.
Head body, using the open palm to just bother his face. Hammer blows to the head, elbow to the head now. He's got the crowd behind him. Inside the final 80 seconds, forearm on the throat, glove on the face. Blows to the forehead. Forearms again. It's not looking good for Perpetuo.
He's got a minute left to go.
He's got that cut around the eye as well, Gianni. It's not easy for him there. Taking more punishment.
Hammer fist and short elbows by Tetsuka.
And again, the back of the head is a possibility. The referee's looking very carefully at that. Safety absolutely paramount in one championship. And that'll be the referee's priority.
Perpetuo taking some deep breaths.
Yeah, he's got his eyes closed. Gianni's just looking to survive. The hand in the face there, that's going to be really troublesome for him. Controlling that head, not allowing him to do anything offensively. It's all Perpetuo can do now to just try and defend himself. Tetsuka's looking for the big blow, isn't he? He's going in there where the legs are potentially very dangerous. If he meets one of those high kicks, he's in a lot of trouble. The crowd here behind me making a lot of noise. The final 10 seconds of the first two rounds were absolutely intense, and it looks like they're going to be here as well. Now, we're looking there, I think, at a kick to a grounded opponent, are we? I think that's what the referee's not happy with. He was sending in up kicks, but as soon as Tetsuka was technically grounded, then those kicks are technically illegal. It was all a little bit messy. I'm sure it wasn't intentional. He's had his eyes closed for the best part of the last minute or so anyway. But I think he's getting a warning there. They'll reposition themselves. And this is good refereeing, if I'm interpreting that correctly. He's allowed to up kick while Tetsuka's on his feet. Go. As he is now. Oh, intense stuff. And the referee has to put his body on the line in order to separate those two. Such was the intensity of the contest, but just take a look at that. It's the honor that we see in one championship, time after time after time. After 15 minutes of intense warrior behavior, they show respect, the like of which you really don't see too often.
Your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner.